All right, hello. This is Hot Plate Pottery, Justine speaking, and we are going to do this little tutorial about the Fuse Glass ThinkSpring Sun Catcher. It's super functional. You can have it hanging on a wall or on a window, whichever you prefer. And so we're just gonna get started. I have a plain base here. In your kit, you should have all of the glass that's needed for the project. You will have one set of tool here. These are your snips, so you can snip into different shapes. You have two different type of glass. There is transparent, where you can see the light through it, or it's see-through. And then opaque, where you cannot see the light through it. Okay. Either works for a sun catcher, especially mine. I have lots of opaque pieces on there as well as transparent. I will show you two ways how to sprinkle your frit on there and that kind of thing. So frits are these little pieces in the background here. They're like sprinkles, and they're just grinded up pieces of glass. So they'll look like this. And these little cups here, there are fine and coarse and medium. So this is medium, so there's a little bit more texture. And then there's coarse, so there is a lot more texture. Okay. There is also transparent and opaque of the frit, just so you know. It should be labeled on your kit lids. There are the stringers. This is what I used for the stems on the flowers here. And these ones just can break with your fingers, just super easy, like so. Pretty much like pasta noodles. And then you have your cup of glue. This is just Elmer's glue. This is just to hold down your pieces so they don't go flying off when you put them back in your to-go kit. And Q-tips and toothpicks to glue down your glass with. So you only need one dab of glue on your glass. And you wanna make sure all of your pieces are on your base and not hanging off the edge, just because it will do something crazy. So you wanna make sure it's on your edge and go from there. All right, so you can draw on your piece with a marker here. Permanent marker, Sharpie brand, usually burns off in the kiln. Any other brand, I'm not sure. Crayola marker usually burns off, or dry erase marker. So I'm just gonna divide this down here so I can show you the two ways. I will put down frit first, and then I'll put down my design first, so then you can see which one that you like better. You can draw out your flowers if you like. So if you don't want to follow my design, that's fine. If you have something else in mind, go ahead and do that. We appreciate when people can be able to do their own creation on there, so you can have some artistic freedom. We also have these dots, so some of these should be in your kits. These are nice for little centers of your flowers, or even just making the petals. This tall one is right in the middle here. And you want to be aware you are handling glass, so you want to be really careful when you're handling it. Just be aware that it is sharp, some of the pieces, and pointy, and can result in little ouchies on your skin, so like just want to make sure when you're handling the sharp piece here that you don't intentionally stab it into your hand. Now I'm just gonna mark kind of like where I want my frit to separate into different colors. Really rough draft of it. Okay, so you can see how the sample is and how I just kind of dotted that. I usually always have a white piece of paper underneath my base just because I might see busy background. So the white gives me that solid background so I can see exactly what I'm doing. So on this side I will do the frit, and on this side I will just start my flowers. So with the frit, I usually say dip your Q-tip in the glue, and you're just going to paint a very light layer or thin layer of the glue. All right. This is where I'll sprinkle my blue. All right, and I'm not going to flip it like this, like how people do with glitter. I want as much as that color to stay on, just because I know that it will become more transparent once it goes through the kiln. Adding more glue. And just a light sprinkle of white frit that is the finer stuff. Okay. I'm just gonna leave a little space where it is just clear. And add the light green that is opaque, this one. And I'm just gonna kind of sprinkle it down here as well, just so I can have it blend a little bit better. Then I will be taking the transparent green. So it's a slightly darker green. I'm doing right underneath here. So the thing with this, it does cover up your design a little bit more than having it like this. Okay, sprinkle a little bit up there in my light green. All right, and then I'm going to add my thicker pieces of my frit, so the more coarse. down here. And so I have light green, yellow. Dark green, so these are all the chorus pieces. And then I have an aqua blue color. And this one is transparent, so it's just gonna kind of blend. All right, so I have my base down of my frit. For that one side. Now I'm going to add my stringers here. So I'm kind of measuring where I have that stem so I can decide if I need to break it at all, which I don't. These ones, I just kind of dip the glue in both sides and place it down in the desired spot. You can always move it around with a toothpick. If it's not in the right spot, you can kind of perfect it that way. Then I have my little branches, I guess you could say, coming out from here. So my dandelion puff. And it's getting stuck to my finger because of the glue. Just take the toothpick and make sure it's wiped off from the glue and just sticking it down into that spot.